After watching a horror movie at the age of 12, Tara Lawson and her brother talked their mother into buying a Ouija board.
We just got a Parker Brothers Ouija board at the toy store, and we didn't realize that, you know, it was more than just a toy.
What started out as an innocent fascination turned Tara's life into a nightmare filled with oppression. An evil presence made itself known almost immediately.
It was moving her hands across the board, and it was moving really fast. And we were looking up at my dad, just kind of laughing, like, look, and we're not doing it.
It was spelling out this profanity. And they were looking up at me and laughing. And I was like, that sent some cold chills up your spine. So I said, give me that thing. I said, we're not playing this anymore. I said, I'm getting rid of it.
Tara's dad hid the board. It wasn't long, though, before Tara found it and secretly began playing again.
To me, it was just kind of something that was like a game, something that was just fun for me. I didn't realize the extent of the damage it could do in my life, what I was opening myself up to, that it was something demonic, something evil.
But the more she played, the more frightened she became.
I had it underneath my dresser. I would get so scared, I couldn't sleep, knowing it was under there.
She came back and said, you know, I found that Ouija board, I've been playing it again, and I can't sleep, it's bothering me. Would you please get rid of it?
Tara and her father burned the Ouija board, but a few years later, she was drawn back to it again. This time, she made her own Ouija board with a friend.
That one was even more powerful than the one before, moved even stronger. It would say all kinds of wild stuff, and then it would just start saying all this inappropriate things. So being teenage girls, we just would kind of laugh and feel kind of uncomfortable, but we keep playing. And I could tell it was spelling something, but it was going so fast, I couldn't tell what it was spelling, but I saw my name, and it was saying, I'm gonna kill you, Tara. I'm gonna kill you, Tara, over and over. We ended up saying, our Father which art in heaven, is all we really knew to say. And it went to goodbye immediately.
She stopped playing with the Ouija board, but Tara's life was dominated by loneliness and fear.
I felt so alone. I felt like I didn't have anybody. It's almost like I was under this dark cloud of oppression. I opened that door to evil into my life. It brought in destruction. It brought in a dark oppression over my life. It seemed like everything from that point forward was spiraling downward.
Strange things occurred around her. Objects moved through her room at night, and loud noises would echo through the house when no one else was home.
I heard them stomping up and down the hall, and I thought, oh, my dad's home, and he is not too happy. And so I ended up looking out in the hall, and there was nobody there.
Tara eventually got married and moved out of the house, but the darkness went with her.
I would hear this loud, evil chanting. I didn't understand the language. It didn't really sound like a human voice. It didn't sound like a human voice could talk in that tone and be that loud.
Then, late one night,
he was still up and I was asleep, and he looked in the hall and he saw this dark figure in the hall. And he ended up just saying a prayer to himself and it disappeared.
Tara's marriage eventually fell apart. One night as she slept, she had a vivid dream that she was violently murdered.
I closed my eyes and said, God, please get me out of here. I was like, please just save me. It just hit me that one day I'm gonna die. One day I'm gonna die, and I don't know if I'm gonna go to heaven or hell. So I just started praying to God. I called out to him. I said, God, please, please show me what to do to be saved. I don't even know what to do, but I know I don't wanna go to hell.
The answer to her prayer came early the next day.
The next morning, I hear a knock on the door, and I went to the door, and there was a man standing there with a Bible. He said, I just wanted to come in and read some of the Bible with you and pray with you, and I was like, yeah. He read John 3:16 with me, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whoever shall believe in him shall have everlasting life.
Tara prayed to become a Christian. Her life was instantly transformed.
It changed everything. It's like everything woke up in me. It's like I was looking at things through new eyes, a new perspective, through his eyes. I mean, it was just, I was changing day by day. I've never felt that kind of love before in my life. And it was just amazing how quickly that transformation took place when his presence came into my life. It was darkness into light.
Tara is now a prayer counselor with the 700 Club. Her days of darkness are a distant memory, yet now serve as a warning to others.
The Ouija board was just an open door for all that that took place. And the only thing that stopped it was me turning my life over to Jesus. I feel like he's always there protecting me, and I don't have anything to worry about. He's right there guarding over me, looking after me. Even when I'm alone, I don't feel alone because I feel like he's right there with me, and he's never going to leave me. He's never going to forsake me. He made my life beautiful. He can make anyone's life beautiful.